Thank you. Frey, how can I assist thee, penitent one? This mallet is so wonderfully balanced in the hand that it feels quite effortless to move. Know that you have my gratitude, penitent one. May the hands of the miracle guide thee, penitent one.
So be it. The sacrament has been completed. Now go in peace.
Open up the skin and red flesh. Uncover the lie that my shell conceals, for I am only blood and bones. So allow the chalices to be filled with those who toast kings and priests. Bring me chalices and vials, and I shall fill them with mine own blood. Bring me chalices. Bring me chalices.
Come closer and contemplate this delicate tumbaga. The embroidered shawls, the silk dresses. You are in Rehima's shop. My goods are my home, my bed. They are as much a part of me as I am of them. You point, and this diligent arm will surely grant your request. Here among my wares, I shall await your return.
Oh, blessed are we, for I behold a penitent. humbly allow us to present ourselves to your reverence. We are Medardo and Escolastico, pilgrim merchants and scribes by trade. You never know where precious assets may be. What prey can be unjust or malevolent in walking the roads in pursuit of a twofold profit? That of the pocket by selling, and that of the spirit by prayer. While Medardo pays penance in his meditative meanderings, I take care of the business side of things, sparing not a drop of ink to write about the beautiful landscapes of the many varied paths we travel. But go ahead and cast your eyes upon our shop window. The objects that were lost on voyages have great appeal and fascination, as they have become a reminder of the feat itself. Cast your eyes upon our shop window. Until our paths cross again, Penitent One.
The wood is taking shape. I sense how its veins nourish a body that seeks to be wounded with my chisels and hammers, that yearns for the cuts and indentations that will free it from its coarse origins. May the hands of the miracle guide thee, Penitent One.